Hello and welcome in this Omnivista eDemo. I'm Benjamin Rougeau, Network Solution Architect, and I am your speaker for this demo. The demo script is this very demo, in which we will do a tour of Omnivista capabilities. Don't forget to read the platform information document, in which you can find more information about this demo, the Omnivista URL, and the user to connect. Here are the topics that will be covered in this demo. We will not go into details for each. The goal is to have an overview of all the capabilities that Omnivista can offer. Please note that the Omnivista used in this demo is the on-premise version OV2500, but all features and even the graphical interface is exactly the same if you use the cloud version called Omnivista Cirrus. So you can follow this demo even if you are interested into Omnivista Cirrus. This quick introduction is finished, so now let us begin. Okay, so right after you connect to Omnivista, you will see this main page. So this is the main dashboard. A few information about this dashboard. So this is fully responsive, so you can zoom in and zoom out, and you will see the widget adapt to the new zoom. You can also use this dashboard for phones and for tablets. And another thing is that you can customize the dashboard for each user. So we can change, for example, the layout and the number of widgets per user, per column, sorry. And you can also delete or add some widgets if you don't want them. Regarding the widgets, all widgets are interactive. So we can see in this one, for example, the alarm widget. I can directly click on the widget and remove some information that I don't want. So for example, I just remove the minor alarms. And if I click on one type of alarm, I will go directly to the menu regarding this alarm with the correct filter. So this is a good thing. This is more easy to access to an information thanks to this interactive feature. So you can see more information, the network health, for example, the memory, the temperature. So we are in the global dashboard, so we have both information about Wi-Fi and switches. So we have here, for example, the rogue AP and the interfering AP. So you get the idea. I will not go through all the widgets, but you have access to the OV, so you can check them all if you want. If you use Omnivista only for WLAN, only for Wi-Fi, you can select a view for Omnivista to see only the information about WLAN. So you go up into this little box and you select the WLAN menu, and you will see all the menu will adapt, and you can access in that way more quickly to all the information, all the menu relative to Wi-Fi configuration. So instead of going in a sub-menu, you will have access directly to this menu. And we can go back in the regular menu for this demo. Now I will show you the menu to see the inventory of all devices managed by Omnivista. So you go in Network, Discovery, and Manage Device. And here, thank you, you will see all the devices managed by Omnivista. So you have the LAN and WLAN devices. So you can see a lot of information. So the name, the friendly name, the IP address, the MAC, the status if you have some alarm. And you have a lot more information if you want. And the version, this is something important. You can also display some information in the form of graph. So I like two type of graph. I like the type. The type graph and the version graph. So the type graph is this one. You can see all number of devices you have in your network. So for example, I have 5 AP 1201. I have 4 6250, etc. I like this graph because you can see the number of each devices, and when you deploy a new configuration on one type of devices. So if you want to deploy a configuration on all access switches, for example, you will see exactly how many switches will be impacted by your new configuration. You can also see, if you want to renew your devices, your network, how many switches you have. For example, if you want to renew all the 6250, in that case, you have 4, so you need to replace 4 switches. So I think this is a pretty good menu. And another one that I like is the version menu, so the version graph. This graph displayed all the devices version in your network, so you can quickly see if some of your devices not comply with your version policy you have in your company. Okay, so back to the main table. Now I will show you how to discover new devices with OmniVista. So this is something you cannot do with your read-only account, so I will show you how to do it. So the idea is simple. You first need to create a range of IP addresses, as we can see here. You map this range to a discovery profile that contains an SNMP user and password. You launch the discovery, and each IP you declare in your range will be tested with the SNMP user you define in the discovery profile. At the end of the process, you will have a summary of each added devices. So I just do a quick test. So we can see that the OV is trying to discover all the IP that are in range. I'm not sure it will work because this is already the devices are already discovered. So, but you will see this type of resume. Discovery complete. The next feature I want to cover is the locator feature, the locate. So you go in network and locator. So in this menu, you can search a device with different filters. So you can search not only the device, you can search for a user, an authenticated user, for a MAC address or for an IP address, a host address. For this example, I did connect with an authenticated user called demo user. So auth user, demo user, and you go. And you will have the result will be all the place where the user were in the time. So I did connect only once in one IP. So I have only one reply from the OV, and I can see some information about this user in that case. So the client IP address, the MAC address, the devices, at what time, the VLAN ID, for example. So this is something that is quite useful. So if the user connected at multiple place, at multiple time, you will see a row for each place and each time the user connect to the network. So it can be very great to see how many times a user connect and disconnect in a day, at which place. It can be useful for a large type of scenario. Okay, so now I want to show you the place where we can see all the alarm, all the notification sent by the devices. So you go in network, notification, notification home. So in that place, we'll see all the alarm sent by your devices. So again, switches and APs. So be aware that This page is live, so you don't have to reload the page to have new alarm. So you can display this page on a big screen in your room and see all the alarm for all operator to see the alarm. You can also filter the alarm, of course. So you go into this menu and for example, we can filter per API group. So we need to select the API group. We can also filter by name or by severity. So for example, I will choose these two type of severity. So for this API group only, I click on apply and we can see that I have three critical alarms sent by this API group only. And of course, you can click on each notification, on each alarm to see more information about the alarm. And you can reset all the filter by clicking on reset all. Very simple. Okay, so now I want to show you the application visibility and the analytics part. So application visibility first, you need to go in network, application visibility, device management. So basically application visibility is DPI, so deep packet inspection. So not all devices can do DPI. So here is a list of all devices that support application visibility. So we can see auto update. So typically all information gathered by those devices can be found in the analytics menu. So now we want to see all the analytics gathered by those devices. So you go in network, analytics, and reports. So we have a lot of reports, but for this case, the most useful case, in fact, top N application, and in our case, I will select all 6860 and APs. In fact, I want to show you some information on APs. So this tab is enough. So I click on it and I can see some information. The first thing is the application statistic by flow. So we can see all the flow gathered by APs. And we can see that we have a lot of flow. We can go into the setting menu and we can edit what we want to display. So 50 apps is a little too much. So for example, I can select 15. I can also change the date. Okay, this is better. So you can see all the flow. You can also click on it to have more details about which IP generate this flow. You have also the top user per application. So again, you can edit some detail about the time period time. And you can choose some application detected by the API. So for example, I can select FaceTime and I can see that two devices did FaceTime during this period of time I configured. We can, for example, choose another one. So which one can be great? Netflix, for example. Okay, so in that case, I can see two devices did some Netflix, and one is major. And the other tab, top application per user. So in that case, you need to select a user, an IP user. So I have this IP that I did some flow with it. And I can see with this IP, I did some Rainbow, some Google accounts, okay, GStatic, and some Google Play. So this is a type of flow, of course. Google Play basically is the ad that you have when you launch your Google Store. You can have some ads. So you need to know sometimes what is the flow behind the name. But yeah, this is a analytics menu, and we can see that we have a lot of reports. So the top end application advance that I show you, the top end clients, the network health, etc. So for your information, this demo is done with some data I generate myself. So maybe when you connect to the OV, you will not have access to all the same data as me. So this is why I wanted to show you the same graph that I show you. Okay, so now I will show you the IoT tab in OmniVista, so the Internet of Things. You click on network, you go white, IoT and inventory. So you can see in this menu all IoT connected to your network or not. So we can see a lot of devices that are active. So all those devices are currently connected to the network. And we can see some other devices that are offline. So they are either disconnected or just powered off. Okay, so all IoT is detected by OmniVista and by the switches or APs. We can also connect IoTs in Wi-Fi. So you have the IP of the IoT, the MAC, and each IoT will be categorized into a specific category. So we can see a lot of examples. We have a lot of here. We can see that we have a lot of Windows, and all that Windows is running on HP laptop. So the category is operating system. So the manufacturer and the endpoint name is gathered again by the API or the devices using DHCP option and some requests that may be sent by specific IoT devices like cameras. And of course, we will use the MAC address to determine in which manufacturer the devices is belong. Okay, so we have the endpoint name and the most important thing is the UNP. So with OV and with all the devices, Alcatel-Lucent Enterprise devices, you can apply a UNP to each devices. So here we can see that we have a specific UNP applied to these devices. And this one, another type of devices has another UNP. So a UNP is a set of rules, of QoS rules, that are applied to a devices. So you can configure in this UNP the bandwidth, for example, bandwidth throughput, bandwidth upstream. You can also, so this is QoS, so you can remove the access to an IP, to an application. This is basically QoS, and you can apply a specific UNP to a category of devices. You can go into the category menu. So we can see here all the category by default created in OmniVista. And we can see that the last one, the camera one, is a custom one. So this is one we created ourselves. So all the devices will be categorized in one of these categories. And the last part is enforcement. So this is what I told you with the UNP. So you have here all the category name, and for each category name, you can select a specific UNP or access role profile. This is the same to apply to all the devices that belong to this category. Another thing, a UNP is mapped to a VLAN, so you can do IoT containment with that. When you connect a devices, for example, a camera, this is different that you connected a laptop, and you may want to have them to different VLAN, to different logical network. So if you have an IRP, an access role profile for camera, when the devices is connected, when the devices will connect to the network, you will apply this set of rules of QoS, and you will put these devices into the specific VLAN. So this is IoT containment. And you can do this for all categories. What I show you, the enforcement part, you will not be able to do it with the read-only menu. So only this part will be gray for you. This is why I wanted to show you this part. Okay, so now I will show you how to configure and to see all UNP and access role profile. So this is the same name. This is two different names for the same thing, sorry. So you go into Unified Access, Unified Profile, you click on Template, and then in the left part, you click on Access Role Profile. So here we can retrieve our ARP camera that I applied before. So again, with your read-only account, you will not be able to go into this edit menu. This is why I show you now. So, okay, so here we can see all the settings for the ARP, the access role profile. So we have a bunch of specific things. And here we can apply a policy list. A policy list is the set of QoS to block or to whitelist some IP, some application. So you first need to create some policy, to create a policy list, and after you apply this policy list to this access role profile. So all the devices will have the same rule defined by this policy list. Another setting that are quite interesting and about QoS again, is the bandwidth control settings. So you can configure the upstream bandwidth, downstream, all things that you can already do on CLI. But here, this is much easy to do it, of course. And we can select a bunch of other few things that are quite specific regarding your network. But this is the menu to configure some ARP. Okay, so after you configure your IRP, you need to apply it to all the devices that you want. So I will cancel this one. So again, you will not be able to do it with your read-only account. You click on Apply to Device, and in this menu, so like I said, you can map, you have to map the ARP to a VLAN. So in that case, this is a VLAN 2. You can also add multiple VLAN if you want. But yeah. And then you will apply the ARP to a list of switches or a list of AP group. So a list of AP. So yeah, I can show you. You select a list of AP. You have to select a VLAN. So for example, I will select the VLAN 100. And then you apply. That means that all devices that will be put into this ARP or UNP, this is the same thing again, will be mapped to the VLAN 100 with a set of policy I configured into this ARP, so with the policy list that I configured, and if I have them, some bandwidth settings. Okay, so now I will change of topic. I want to show you the topology part that we have. So you go into network and topology. So the first type of topology is the geographical topology. So we can see the entirely map and all the sites that we created in your network. So you need to define an address, a location, and you will have a site on the map. You will also see the number of devices for each site and the color depends of the type of alarm the device inside face off. Okay, so you can zoom in if you want. You can also see the geolocation, the address of the site. And you can go to topology to go into this site topology. So for this site, our site in Paris, so I uploaded the map and I define all the devices that are currently into our network. So the location of each devices. We can see the alarm of each devices, the IP address. If I click on it, I can access to more information. I can also edit the device, more information about the port, if I want to save the configuration. I can also directly connect into SSH to these devices. This is pretty useful. I use this feature quite a lot. And okay, so we can see the map, you can edit the map. So of course with your read-only account, we will not be able to do it again, but this is something that is possible. And you can also have submap into your primary map, I would say. So for example, this is the ground floor or the first floor. And I set another map, the second floor in this building. So if I click on it, I access to the second floor. So you go upstairs and you access to the second floor. And this is the same. You need to upload a map and you can edit the location of each devices. Next thing I wanted to show you is how to upgrade software image with OmniVista. So you go in configuration, resource manager, upgrade image. So the first thing to do is to import the new version that you have. So thanks to the import button. Next, you will see all the versions that you upload in OmniVista in here. Next, you need to select the version that you want. So for example, I can select this one and to click on install. So I can see here all the versions for each AP according to this version. I click on next. And next, I need to select the AP group. So I will apply this software image to this AP group. Okay, so next, and I will have a resume, a summary of what will be done with this thing. And you click on install software. Of course, I will not do it. But again, you will not be able to do it with your read-only account. So I wanted to show you that this is possible and very simple to upgrade image with OmniVista. Next topic, I will show you the WLAN menu and the SSID menu and how to create a SSID. So you click in WLAN and you go into SSIDs. So here we can see all SSIDs that are deployed on your AP group, on your network. So you can see very quickly here the name of your SSID, the usage of your SSID. So this one is a PSK network, so a network with only a password. Here I have 802.1nix network. I can also have a guest network, a BYUD network. And we can see some more detail about all those networks. I wanted to show you how to create a network. You cannot do it with your read-only account. This is why I will show you how to do it very quickly, because this is pretty easy. So you click on Add, and first you need to select SSID name and the usage of your network. So you have a bunch of usage. In my case, I will not go into all detail, but I will create 802.1nix network. This is the most secure network that you can have. Create and customize. So this is the main part of creating your network. So by default, we have some pretty good configuration. So you can change the allowed band for your network. So by default, this is all channel, not channel, all bands that are available. You can also choose a constraint type, but by default this is the better one that is chosen. You can also add some MAC authentication if you want. I will not do it. The primary thing to set up for Edo2 Domain X is authentication strategy. So if you want to have your employee account defined in OV or in an external server, it will not be the same configuration. I will not go into detail because we have an architecture guide about UPAM, so this part of OmniVista, that define all type of authentication types that you have in OmniVista with an external server, the UPAM, the OV Radius server with a captive portal. So I will not go into detail right now, but you can refer to this document. So for example, in that case, by default, the Radius server defined is a UPAM Radius server. So basically, this is the OV that will act as the Radius server. So in that case, I need to create all users into my OV by clicking into this button. So I can show you very quickly. So I have, for now, only one account named Doctor. I can also, so if you want an external server, click on the Radius server box and choose another server, or click on Add New to create another server. So you need to choose the server and to add the secret, of course. The advanced configuration, again, not into detail, it defined into detail into this architecture guide that we have. So this is okay for the first primary part. And the next thing to do, so the access policy, we don't have to select it, to edit it. This is clearly not not important. And the next part is to select the access role attribute. So do you remember when I create before an access role profile? So this menu will create an access role profile mapped to this SSID. This is mandatory to have an access role profile. So if you don't have one, by default, this is the first case, you need to select so the VLAN. This is the same menu as for the access role profile that we saw before. So you can select a VLAN. So again, I will select an example VLAN. And you can add some ACL, QoS policy, and some other thing if you do some specific configuration. But if you already have an access role profile, you select choose existing access role profile, and you select one of the access role profile. So I can retrieve the ARP camera that we saw before. So for this example, I will just create a new one. And that's it, basically. Save and apply to an API group. And this is the last step. So you need to select an API group to apply your new SSID. So the default group, okay, this is my default, this is my group with all my APs in it. And you click on apply. You need to wait a little bit. And after that, your SSID will be broadcasted in your IPs. Okay, so now that we created SSIDs and we know how to do it, we want to see if we have a good coverage in our building, in our map. So for that, we have in fact two tools. The first one is a predictive tool. So I will show you right away. You go into WLAN floor plan. So you create a floor plan. Again, we'll have a read-only, so you cannot edit the floor plan that I have. So I have created a floor plan. I go into it. Okay, not this part. In here, you put the floor file. You go into the floor map. Okay, So in here, we can retrieve exactly the same map that we saw before in the topology view. So this is a predictive tool. We can see that this is the same map with some obstacle that I configure. And we can see some APs. The colors, so the heat map, show the RSSI of each frequency. So we can see here that we have a pretty good coverage in this part. We have also a pretty good coverage in this part, and we have a little issue in this one near the entrance. So I will show you how I did it. So edit floor plan. So you enter this mode. So you first need to draw the obstacle. You have two choices. You can deploy manually the APs, or you have the auto deployment button. So this is pretty useful if you have a big building but you need to draw all obstacles. So for this example, I will not do it because I only use this part of our floor. So okay. So the next part is to deploy the APs to see if we will have a good SSID, a good coverage. So we go into this part and we can see all the APs available for OmniVista, for your network. And we saw, I will stop and I will show you again. And we saw that in the entrance we have a small gray zone. So this is an issue for me because this gray zone is the entrance of our showroom, and this is a place where we do the introduction speech to this place and to the agenda. So we want to have a good coverage in it because visitors may want to connect to the network right after they enter this place. So we want to have a good coverage in here. But we also don't want to move this AP because in that place we also have some speech and some audience at this place. So we don't want to move this AP. So we will add another one. I go into the edit mode again. I can select in here an AP. So this is a small place. I don't need to select a big AP like this one. I will select a smaller one. So the 1222. This is an example. I click on it and I deploy it on the map. So this is this simple. You can also, if you want, modify the AP power of each AP in Debian. If you want to increase or reduce your coverage, so you still want to have the good PoE power, this is other issue, but you can edit the dBm of each AP. Okay, so I will put into this place because I know that I have some walls, I have some something in here to put the AP. And now I will quit this mode and save. And now we can see that we have a good coverage in this place that I wanted to have a good coverage. So this is a good thing. This tool is pretty useful because you don't have to actually have the AP to test it. If you only have LAN equipment, you can also use this predictive tool if you plan to have some APs in your network. Okay, so it was the first tool, so called floor plan, and we also have the other tool. So this is not predictive, this is an active mode, but to see the same thing. You go into WLAN, and this time you go into heatmap. Okay, so you first need to create the campus, next a building, and next a floor. So again, I will only have one floor. I'm going to this floor, so you need to upload the map, okay, to drop stackle. This is the same thing. But the difference in here is that you deploy only APIs that you actually manage with your NiVista. So you can see that I have some IP addresses. I can click on it. I have more information about them. So this is the active mode. This is your active configuration that you have in your building. You can see in the map, again, you can enable or disable the frequency. So in that case, I only have the 5 GHz frequency enabled. So if I disable it, I see nothing. Okay, but this is the same thing, actually. You will edit the floor map. You will scale the map. So this is something I missed in the previous part, but you need to scale the map. This is very easy. You just have to draw a line like this. So and you put the distance. This is very easy. And next, you add AP to the floor. So I don't have any more AP because I already deployed them all. But this is the same thing. But in that case, you have more information about where each AP is in your building. So you have the active configuration of each AP. So this is the same thing, but in an active mode, in an active way. Very quickly, I will show you all the captive portal page integrated with OmniVista. So for that, we need to go into UPAM, settings, and captive portal page. So we can create some page, some different page. I will edit it. So again, we will not be able to do it. This is why I show you. And so this is the default portal page that you will have when you connect to a SSID with Captive Portal enabled. So you can change the template. By default, you have this one, but you can change the template. You can have one with some ads at the right. You add some other templates that are quite different. You have another template that you can add a video inside it. And the last one, you have the Wi-Fi for you portal layout. So if you have this type of SSID of augmentation in your network, you can use this template. Now I will stay in the WLAN topic. I want to show you the radio frequency profile that you can apply to a network. So this is quite complex, but no worry about that. So you go in WLAN, RF, so radio frequency, and RF profile. So you can see here all RF profiles. So this is the same ID. You define your RF profile and you apply it to an IP group. So all the IP part of this IP group will have the same configuration. And you click on default profile and you click on edit. Again, you will not be able to do it, but it's easier for me to show the configuration. So this is a specific configuration about the radio frequency of each IP. So not regarding the SSID, but the radio frequency and some specific features that you can retrieve in this menu. So this is quite complex, but we can see something interesting. So the smart load balance, if you want to enable band steering or to force all devices to go into the 5 GHz band. You can also configure the RSSI threshold. I will not go into detail. But you have a lot of information that you can configure in here if you want to have a specific network. But yeah, this is quite complex. This is why I wanted to show you this menu. So in each menu, in OmniVista, you have this little help button. You click on it, you have a new page, and this page explains you quite good, quite well, all the details about the menu that you see. So all the settings, it explains all the settings. So for example, in here, short guard interval, you have some more detail about this specific option. So this is quite a good good information. I use this menu quite a lot to be sure what I will configure. So this is pretty useful. Even if you are in a complex menu, you don't very know what this menu is for. You click in the help button, you read it, and you will understand the menu and the features. And the next and last topic we will cover in this video is the WLAN list of clients. So we first need to go into WLAN and client. So we have a few menus here. So we will go into them all. So into this main dashboard, we can see first the client density, so the number of clients connected to the network. So I select a period of time, so the same period of time when I was generating traffic. Again, you will connect to the OV and you may not have exactly the same information, but you can retrieve this information into this menu. So the client number and the time. So I select a period of time. You can also select a specific SSID to see how many devices are connected to one SSID. You can see the download and upload throughput, again, in this period of time with all the filters you configure. So okay, you can drag your mouse here to see more information about each in data. So I don't have a lot of data because this is an environment demo and we don't have a lot of traffic this time. But yeah, information can be retrieved here. Next thing is the client list. I will show you the wireless client list. Not this menu. Okay, the wireless client list. So the first thing is a distribution of client per IP. So you see the number of IP and the number of clients. So currently, I have 5 IP with no client connected to it. And I have 1 IP with 1 to 9 clients. So again, this is an environment demo. So the graph is not very useful for us. But if you have a much bigger network, so you can easily reach 60 and more users in your entire network. So you can have a pretty good graph and that shows the number of distribution that you have in your network. If you have a good RF profile configured, you can show this kind of problem into this menu. And then go into the RF profile to troubleshoot it, for example. Then you have the whole IP list that you have in your network, and this is interactive. So if I select no IP list, I can see that I have no client connected because I have no IP selected. And if I select all the IP, I can see that I have 2 devices connected to those IP. So this is interactive, this is pretty good. Again, if you want to see the location, the stick device, hein, because a device can be sticky to a specific IP and not do roaming. So you can see that in here. And again, about roaming, you can click on one specific client. So you can block list kickoff, okay. And you can go into show roaming and RSSI history. So this is pretty good if you want to do some coverage test. Hein. You put a device, you take a device and you go roam into your network to see if you have a pretty good RSSI. So you can see here the RSSI in time of your device. And you can also see the associated SSID at each time of your device. So this is pretty interesting to do a coverage study of your network. If you have again some issue with your roaming, you can use this menu to help with that. This demo is ended, so has this video. Don't forget to give us feedback about this demo. Feedback is the best way to improve ourselves and help us a lot to deliver better quality content. One day after your demo is complete, you will receive an email to ask for your feedback. Be honest about it, because we only want to improve. Thank you for your involvement. We hope this video helps you understand OmniVista and its features. I'm Benjamin Rougeau, Network Solution Architect, and I'll see you next time for more network-related content.